Hello students, in this video we are going to see about ellipse. So we obtain different kinds of conic sections depending on the position of the intersecting plane with respect to the cone and by the angle made by it with the vertical axis of the cone. Here beta be the angle made by the intersecting plane with the axis of the cone. When beta lies between alpha and 90 degree, the section is an ellipse. Here we have horizontal ellipse and vertical ellipse. An ellipse is the set of all points in the plane, the sum of whose distances from the two fixed point, so this fixed point F1 and F2 in the plane, which is a constant. So an ellipse is a set of all points in a plane, the sum of whose distances from two fixed points in the plane is a constant. The two fixed points are called the foci. Here we have two foci, so it is foci of the ellipse. The constant, which is the sum of the distances of a point on the ellipse from two fixed point, is always greater than the distance between the two fixed points. The midpoint of the line segment joining the foci, which is called the center of the ellipse. The line segment through the foci of an ellipse is called the major axis. So this is major axis. The end points of the major axis are called the vertices of the ellipse. Here the line segment through the foci of the ellipse, which is called the major axis, and the line segment through the center and perpendicular to the major axis, which is called the minor axis. The end points of the major axis, so this point, which are called the vertices of the ellipse. We denote the length of the major axis is by 2a. So length of the major axis is 2a and length of the minor axis is 2b. Here the vertices are given. So its length of the major axis is 2a, length of the minor axis is 2b, and the distance between the two foci, which is 2c. So length of the semi-major axis, so length of the semi-major axis is a and length of the semi-minor axis is b. Then standard equation of an ellipse. Here it is the horizontal ellipse and this one is the vertical ellipse. Here the major axis is along x-axis and the minor axis is along y-axis. Here the major axis is along y-axis and the minor axis is along x-axis. So the standard equation of the ellipse with center h, k and major axis is 2a and minor axis is 2b, where c square equal to a square minus b square. Then the equation will be x minus h whole square by a square plus y minus k whole square by b square, which is equal to 1. When the major axis is horizontal and the center is 0, 0, then the equation is x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1. When the major axis is vertical, so this diagram, when it is vertical, then the equation will change to x square by b square plus y square by a square equal to 1. So when the ellipse is horizontal, the equation is x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1. When the ellipse is along the vertical, that is along a major axis is along y axis, then the equation will change to x square by b square plus y square by a square, which is equal to 1. Eccentricity. A circle can be described as an ellipse that has a distance from the center to the foci which is equal to 0. The greater the distance between the center and the foci determine the ovalness of the ellipse. Thus the term eccentricity is used to refer to the ovalness of an ellipse. If an ellipse is close to circular, it has an eccentricity close to 0. So eccentricity is denoted by small e. If an ellipse has an eccentricity close to 1, it has a high degree of ovalness. So this shows a picture of two ellipses, one of which nearly circular with an eccentricity close to zero and the other with a high degree of eccentricity. So eccentricity of an ellipsis, the ratio of the distance from the center to the foci and the distance from the center to the vertices. Special cases of an ellipse. In the equation c square equal to a square minus b square, if we keep a fixed and vary c from 0 to a, the resulting ellipse will vary in shape. When c equal to 0, both the foci merge together with the center of the ellipse, then a square equal to b square, that is a equal to b, and so the ellipse become circle. Thus circle is a special case of an ellipse. Then in the case 2, when c equal to a, then b equal to 0, the ellipse reduces to the line segment f1 f2 joining the two foci. Then what is lattice rectum? Lattice rectum of an ellipse is a line segment perpendicular to the major axis through any of the foci here, through any of the foci whose end points lie on the ellipse. So length of the lattice rectum is 2b square by a. Standard equation of an ellipse. So horizontal ellipse, the major axis is along x-axis and the minor axis is along y-axis. Here the vertices is at the end points. So vertices are a comma 0 and minus a comma 0. So foci are ae comma 0 and minus ae comma 0. Standard equation of an ellipse are x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1. Here a square is greater than b square or a is greater than b. For example, we have x square by 25 plus y square by 16, which is equal to 1. So a square is 25, a is 5, b square is 16, b is 4. Here 5 is greater than 4. That is a is greater than 4. Then we have the equation is x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1 when a is greater than b. So length of the major axis is 2a and minor axis is 2b. So c square equal to a square minus b square. So this is a vertical form of ellipse. Major axis is along y axis and minor axis is along x axis. Then we have foci, which is 0 comma plus or minus ae, and vertices we have 0 comma plus or minus a. So major axis is along vertical, then length of the major is 2a, length of the minor is 2b. Then equation will be x square by b square plus y square by a square, which is equal to 1. Here we have x square by b square plus y square by a square. So b square is 16 and a square is 100. B is 4, a is 10. Then the equation will become x square by b square plus y square by a square, which is equal to 1. So if the equation is like this, then the ellipse will be in the vertical form. That is, major axis is along y axis and minor is along x axis. Then c square equal to a square minus b square. Here we are going to see another conic sections, which is hyperbola. Beta lies between 0 and alpha. The section is a pair of intersecting straight lines. It is the degenerated case of a hyperbola. A hyperbola is a set of all points in a plane, the difference of whose distances from two fixed points in the plane is a constant. The term difference that is used in the definition means the distance to the farther point minus the distance to the closer point. The two fixed points are called the foci, here F1 and F2. The midpoint of the line segment joining the foci is called the center of the hyperbola. The line through the foci, which is called the transverse axis. So the line through the foci, which is called the transverse axis, and the line through the center and perpendicular to the transverse axis, which is called the conjugate axis. The point at which the hyperbola intersects the transverse axis are called the vertices of the hyperbola. Here, two vertices. We denote the distance between the two foci by 2c, distance between two vertices. So, length of the transverse axis is 2a and length of the conjugate axis is 2b. A hyperbola also has asymptotes, so that is which passes through the origin, it likes a cross x. So, hyperbola has also asymptotes which cross in an x. Standard equation of hyperbola. Here the transverse axis is along x-axis and conjugate axis is along y-axis. Then the equation will be x square by a square minus y square by b square equal to 1, where b square equal to a square into e square minus 1. Here the transverse axis is along y-axis and conjugate axis is along x-axis. Then the standard equation of the hyperbola is y square by a square minus x square by b square, which is equal to 1. Just like an ellipse, the ratio e equal to c by a, which is called the eccentricity of the hyperbola. Since c is greater than or equal to a, the eccentricity is never less than 1. In terms, eccentricity, the foci are at a distance of ae from the center. So, eccentricity of an ellipse which is not a circle is greater than 0 but less than 1. The eccentricity of a parabola is 1. So, e equal to 1, then it is a parabola. If eccentricity is greater than 1, then it is hyperbola. If e is less than 1, then it is an ellipse. Lattice rectum of a hyperbola is defined as in the case of parabola and ellipse. The ends of the lattice rectum of a hyperbola are ae, plus or minus b square by a square. So, length of the lattice rectum is 2b square by. We have learnt standard equation of an ellipse and standard equation of hyperbola. Thank you, students.